Aigurji, the Social Democrats, Ishakta, Roshi, Short.
Margaret Lascan Corda, and I'd like to join with others in extending congratulations to the Minister for Justice and her husband on the arrival of their new baby, and extend very warm wishes to them. Tánaiste said that people have to see it to be it, and there's no doubt the Minister for Justice has provided very good example, but we also need to see it from government in terms of making provision for senior politicians in terms of providing supports for them during pregnancy and the early months of motherhood. So we'd look forward to that, particularly in the context of the findings of the Citizens' Assembly at the weekend. We look forward to early action from the government in that regard. Tánaiste, a new relationships and sexuality education programme for Catholic primary schools was published this week, as you know, and that was developed by the Irish Bishops' Conference. The programme, in its introduction, states that when discussing LGBTQ+ issues with children, quote, the Church's teaching in relation to marriage between a man and a woman cannot be omitted. We know what that teaching actually is. Relationships between men and women are natural. LGBTQ+ relationships are, quote, intrinsically disordered. As recently as last month, incredibly, the Vatican reaffirmed that the Catholic Church cannot bless same-sex unions because God, quote, cannot bless sin. That is the Church's position. Let's not pretend otherwise. But it is not the state's position. It is not the public's position. We had a marriage equality referendum in this country in 2015, which passed by a huge majority, and same-sex marriage is every bit as valid as heterosexual marriage. Tánaiste, teaching children that relationships can be placed in a hierarchy depending on sexual orientation should be anathema in any modern republic. Do we really want LGBTQ+ children in schools who may be struggling with their sexual orientation to be taught that their relationships are in any way less worthy, meaningful, loving or deserving of respect than their heterosexual peers? Because that is the inference of this programme. This is an issue that doesn't just affect children. Speaking at the INTO's annual conference at the start of the month, INTO Vice President Joe McKeown said that up to 4,000 LGBTQ+ teachers were hiding their sexual orientation because they feared for their job or their promotion prospects, and they feared that those would be harmed if their school patrons discovered their true identity. Tánaiste, you may say that Catholic schools have an ethos, but sex education needs to be fact-based, and facts do not have an ethos. So can you tell me, Tánaiste, why is it that in 2021, relationships and sexual education,
thank you,
sexuality education for Irish
thank
children
you,
is being developed by Catholic bishops and not the NCCA?
Thank you,
why has the Education Minister remained silent on this? And what is the government going to do to ensure pluralism in our schools and that we teach our children mutual respect?
I
just want to thank Deputy Shortall for raising this important matter. The programme for government is very explicit on this, and the programme for government states that the government will develop inclusive and age-appropriate curricula for relationships and sexuality education, RSE, and social, personal and health education, SPHE, across primary and post-primary schools, including an inclusive programme on LGBTI+ relationships. So that is the government policy, it's the government position, and it is what we expect to be upheld in publicly funded schools. As things stand, all schools have to have an RSE policy that has to be developed in consultation with school management, parents, teachers and students as appropriate. And the school's programme for RSE is developed and taught in the context of the school's RSE policy. The ethos of the school should never preclude learners from acquiring the knowledge about the issues, but may influence how the content is treated. Access to sexual and health education is an important right for students, and it's a mandatory part of the curriculum in all primary schools and post-primary schools for a junior cycle. RSE is required at all levels from primary through senior cycle, and the department has set out the content for each of these programmes in SPHE syllabuses and guidelines. The primary level SPHG curriculum is currently used in schools and was published in 1999. Its purpose is to foster the personal development, health and well-being of the individual child, to help him or her to create and maintain supportive relationships and to enable children to make safe and healthy decisions now and into the future. All schools are required to have an RSE policy that is developed in consultation with the school community, including management, parents, teachers and students as appropriate. And the school's programme for RSE is developed and taught in the context of the school's RSE policy. It's important to note that the ethos of the school should never preclude learners from acquiring the knowledge about the issues, but the ethos may influence how it's treated, as I said earlier. In April 2018, a review of RSE in schools was announced. The report was published by the NCCA on the 11th of December 2019. And the NCCA was asked to look at a number of specific issues in relation to RSE and the curriculum, developments in relation to contraception, healthy positive sexual expression and relationships, safe use of the internet and social media, and also relationships and self-esteem and LGBTQ plus matters. The immediate focus of the work was on creating support materials for teachers to support effective teaching and learning linked to the current curriculum. This work is progressing well, and the first section of the toolkit, a portal repository of teaching and learning resources linked to primary SPHE curriculum, the SPHE Junior Cert Short Course and the SPHE Framework, is now published, and the second section is due to be published at the end of April. In tandem with the development of the online toolkit, preparation for redeveloping the SPHE curriculum has begun, with an initial focus on the junior cycle. The review of the current...
Thank you, Tánaiste.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Tánaiste. I think it would be helpful if we had a statement from you or the Minister for Education or the Taoiseach in relation to the new programme that has been developed, because I think a lot of people would have serious difficulty with it, and I think it would be helpful to hear what the government's position is on that. Tánaiste, there are 2,800 Catholic primary schools around the country. 90% of primary schools are Catholic. Do you know how many schools transferred patronage from either the Catholic Church or the Church of Ireland to multi-denominational patron since 2016? It was 8 schools. Last year, just one school was divested, and that was from Church of Ireland to Dublin and Dunleary ETB. One in the entire year, Tánaiste. The snail's pace of the divestment programme is clearly untenable. It is wrong that the Church is given a choice about the type of education children receive, but Irish parents are not. As long as the Church controls 90% of schools, that choice will be absent. This must change, and change is a matter of urgency.
Thank you, Deputy.
What does the government propose to do about this?
Thanks, Deputy. It's very true that transfer of patronage has been very slow in the last couple of years. But I think it's also important that transfer of patronage where it occurs should be done with consent. And I know in my constituency, where we have a reasonable mix of schools, community national schools, Educate Together national schools, Catholic diocese schools and a Church of Ireland school, when you talk to parents, a lot of them will say to you that they like the model that they have. They like the school, the way it works. It ain't broke, don't fix it. Don't throw the baby out of the with the bathwater. So I think it's important that we listen to parents and students where appropriate and ask them what model of education they want. And you'll often find that there are children and families from a diversity of backgrounds attending the local parish Catholic diocese school, and they're not looking for a change in patronage. They like the school, they like the way it operates, and they don't want it to change fundamentally. So, you know, I think we need to bear that in mind as well. You know, very often migrants who come to Ireland want to send their kid to the local Catholic parish school because to them that is integration.
Thank you,
But to come back to your question in relation to the sex ed, you know, the Minister and the Government will make a statement on this, and we need to make a statement on this because the programme for Government is very clear.
Thank you.
And very clear that when it comes to this matter, it has to be inclusive of LGBTI relationships.